Hi, how's everybody doing today? This is Sean, here with another video. Ashley will be joining me later. She went back to the house to go get the speaker. I downloaded a video of me hitting around with Ashley, and she's been playing for about 4 months now, and she just started playing, and for you guys and ladies that are new to my channel, I used to play tennis in the 80s and 90s and into the early 2000s, and then I had some surgeries done, and I walked away from the game about 24 years. So I started playing again, and I've been demoing a lot of different rackets to find out what racket I want to play with it, you know, modern times, because I grew up playing with a Wilson Profile, the 95s, and it's a very stiff racket, very heavy racket. And then one of my buddies in the 90s gave me the 110 version of that, and if you can see how thick this thing is, it's probably about 2.5 of a regular person's racket that they play with now. So I'm gonna try to hit a couple serves. Ashley's pulling up right now, and see how to hit with this, because the new racket that I'll be getting is gonna be the Pure Drive, and it's gonna be a 110, and it's much lighter than this. But since I've already been playing for a long time and already developed, you know, my strokes and how to hit with power without having to cheat by using a different racket, you know, so those rackets are meant for people that can't really hit, you know, by themselves or with a lot of power. So they're just trying to get a little bit extra by using the racket and the strings. Whereas me, the way I grew up, everybody was taught a continental grip, which is like I was showing everybody. They were asking me about these grips. So on the first bevel right there, that would be is if you were to hit a one-handed backhand. And then the second bevel right there is called a continental. And then the third right there is the eastern. And then underneath there is a semi-western is right there, the fourth notch. And then below it is like a frying pan one where you're holding like that. And that's a western grip. So we were taught back in, you know, like in the 80s, to play with everything a continental grip. Your forehand, your one hand backhand, you would just roll it over a little bit and hit like that. And then, you know, your volleys with the continental. So you'd be volleying with this thing. And this is great for doubles. And if you're an older player, and believe it or not, it's lighter than it looks. It's pretty light, but it is head heavy. And then the regular 95s are handle heavy. And as I said, it's because most people were learned how to play with a continental grip, where they just bring it back like this and hit flat with it, you know. And then an eastern grip, you would have a natural, you know, you would have a little bit of natural topspin on it automatically. So the racket I'll be getting will be a 110 like this, but it'll be much thinner, and we're going to show you to you. I'm going to try to hit some serves with this thing because I've played with it in a while, and it's a big racket, and it's really big, wide body. So let me see if I can hit a cone. I haven't taken any serves yet, so thanks. I'd be much on that stuff. Just to get it over the rack. See what I mean? It's a fat frame. So let me take a couple practice. I haven't even warmed up yet, and I gotta get used to throwing the ball correctly with this particular racket. So let's try one. Hasn't been strung in a long time, like a long, long time, probably 25 years or so. So let me, let's try a slice with it. I need my other phone. Well, there's a damper here. That's off the top of the racket too, folks. I'm showing this racket, that's the size I'll be playing with the new one. But that's not gonna be as quick as this thing. Let's hit with a big old girl here. This little thing, they got some size to it, man. Have fun. Good. Sorry. Yeah, I get hit with some pasture with this big old racket. You gotta get used to it though. I think yeah, it would be good for elder people. You just gotta get used to this wide body thing. But I'm gonna go with that Pure Life, or Pure Drive. Love it. I was just a bit out. I just missed it. I'm gonna take my girl out to eat tonight at this new Chinese place. It's an all-you-can-eat buffet. Oh, good job, buddy. I'm gonna keep doing wheelies. It's Friday, and we've been doing pretty good. Why players grunt, guys and women? Well, the way we were taught how to play, ball comes, sort of sideways. You exhale when you hit, and you inhale. So I always just breathe. I always just like when I hit real hard, I catch myself just going. That's about as much noise as I make. But you know. Depends on how you help you breathe. That's all that really matters. Thank you. try this other racket. It's a little thinner. Oops. Almost broke the concrete. Dropping that thing. So I gotta try this one. It's a little thinner. Shot, babe. Every vow you stuff.
Just like you're drinking a glass of porter, that's how you want to hold the tennis ball on the top. Put it out in front of you. Give yourself a better chance of hitting the ball cleaner. And then when you get better at it, you'll be able to use it less. I put the ball underneath my racket like that. That was a bad talking about it. That's my shoulder, that's all. It's better. It's gotten better. When you're throwing in front of you, you can get your leverage and the continental grip. So, Josh went to the concert the other night, and he found this, and gave it to me, because he knows I have a few charms on my necklace, and everybody always asked about this. This is a St. Christopher medal. It was given to me by my grandfather. My grandfather wore this the whole time he was a roofer for 42 years, and all of his life he always wore this St. Christopher. And then this is a St. Michael medal, because that's my baptism name, Michael. And I got this charm here, this four-leaf clover when I was about 18. And then Ashley gave this to me, and then Ashley gave me this cross. And then this is a onyx that she gave me too. So I've had this for about, I don't know, except almost 40 years or more. So he found these, and these are kind of cool. It's got little charms on there. It's Joseph, Mary, Jesus, Saint Michael, George. So it's kind of cool. He gave that to me, and now I'll keep it in my wallet for all the time that I have it. So I was gonna share that with you because it fell out of my pocket earlier, and I was like, "Oh, I'll show the people." See if I can get it to you from over the fence. Did it go over?
Yes.
Nice. Did it go in?
Yes.
Nice. Yeah, you can learn how to hit kick serves by using a fence, folks. Before one of my other videos. got to watch hitting that ball, because if you don't hit it right, it will fire. It will fire right back at you. And most of the people showing you how to do that are pros, so don't really miss them. Shower. It feels good out here. It's like 60 degrees, folks. No, 55, 60 degrees. It's nice out.
Prescribe Nortec ODT or Medicaid 75 milligrams for migraine attacks. Does the fear of running out of medication stop you from treating every migraine attack?
Does it?
About 2 8-packs per month.
Does it?
16 tablets. And most insurance plans cover it.
Nortec ODT is approved for the acute treatment of migraine attacks and preventive treatment of episodic migraine in adults. Don't take if allergic to Nortec ODT or any of its ingredients. Allergic reactions can occur if
you
don't start using.
Take your tablets, dude.
Rash and swelling of the face, mouth, tongue, or throat. Most common side effects were nausea and indigestion, stomach pain. A maximum dose of 75 milligrams can be taken daily to treat migraine attacks or every other day to prevent them. The safety of using more than 18 doses of Nortec ODT in a 30-day period has not been established. For full prescribing information, call 1-833-4-NURTEC or visit Nortec.com.
Double the packs to treat more migraine attacks. Ask your doctor if 2 8-packs of Nortec ODT is right for you.
Put it on the
teeth. Lot of nerves that turn dirty can be a pretty
good
change.
Hard work I'm doing.
Allergy.
It's finally paying off.
But also a chance for you. Like, waking up sleep deprived when you were in bed early listening to a podcast, or looking endlessly at real estate you can't afford. Luckily, there's collagen peptides to support your skin, hair, nail, bone, and joint health. Vital proteins for everybody with a body. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. These products are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Back with like that, folks. Like I just did. When a ball's coming, you want to go like this. Do a triple over your feet. You get hurt doing that. That's not how you should do it. But I played defensive back in football in high school and stuff. And it's similar to that. You want to turn your body sideways. It gives you more room to do stuff too. You're not so one dimensional. Yeah, the scrimps are delicious. Scrimps are delicious. Crappy shots. Always pursue the ball. Don't stop it.
stopping the ball. The direction is
over. We're going to do the all-you-can-eat because they have all different sushis.
Yeah, and they have all-you-can-eat.
I want to go before they close because they're
going to
have...
All I got to do is go home, grab the top, wash my face up, and keep going. We need our exercise, honey. You got to do better.
We can do this. You're doing good. I'm proud of us. I'm proud of you. You're doing great. We're going to go get to the all-you-can-eat buffet, but right now we're going to go to the all-you-can-eat, me smashing some tennis balls and knocking some pounds off this big old fat body. This is damn ridiculous. I'm 52 years old. I shouldn't be looking like this. Although it's medicine for my case. And laziness. I thought I was gonna do the Twitter. No. That's the old school way. That's what people used to do back in the day. That's a great defensive play, especially in doubles. You see how it worked, how it went, and there's spin on it.
Taco Bell just dropped the new cravings value menu.
Oh, you give them? Okay, I got you.
For $3 or less, you can get the food you want for the price you want. It's almost like you can have your cake and eat it too. But in this case, it's a double stack taco from the new cravings value menu. So basically, you can have your double stacked taco and eat it too, which is a lot crunchier than
taco. You miss, baby.
The new cravings value menu is here. Get it at Taco Bell.
Get in the basket.
At participating U.S. Taco Bell location plus supply last. Contact store for price and participation to add. Tax extra. It's a grueling feast.
Can you get it in the basket?
February 3rd to April 7th.
Uh-oh, almost. Come on, we're on top of it. We've been really eating things all day. I have a bad habit of that, folks. You guys do that too? You go all day and forget to eat. I do that. Then I'll eat something about 10 o'clock at night or something. Not heavy stuff, but I've been eating a lot of bananas because of the cramps in my legs. And one of the fellas on here, forget who it was, he was telling me to drink pickle juice for cramps, and thank you, because it works a lot. And then remember I was telling you that diabetes medicine that made me sick, well, it's happening to other patients too. It's just one of those things, one of them kind of medicines that can make people sick. But I was sick like a farm animal, folks. I was waking up at 3 o'clock in the morning just getting sick, and because of this, I thought, because I had to have the hernia repair again, because they put bad mesh in me, I thought it was that too, but it's actually the medicine, so I stopped taking that, and now they're going to give me a shot once a week for the diabetes too, and then I don't have to take all this medicine, and it's a real low dose, so that's going to help me out. So I just wanted to let you know I'm feeling better over that. My friend Nathan was asking. I'm feeling better, Nathan, thank you, and I wanted to say thanks to everybody that watches and gives me support, and obviously, Ashley is trying to hit me with a tennis ball because she wants to go to the all-you-can-eat buffet, Chinese buffet that just opened
you
up.
You wanted to.
I want to also. But you do too. So, yeah, it's fun. We're going to have some fun. I've been just staying at the house most of the time because I'm not working right now because the surgery's coming up. and I don't know what the hell to do with myself. So my goal is, is to get back in shape, you know, play more, and then, you know, play in a tournament, like I was saying, for my age, I'm 52. Then I was gonna start teaching again locally around here, but these people charge a lot of money to teach, and I ain't gonna charge people that kind of money to teach. You know, I do doubles, I teach doubles, and back in the day, we would just charge, you know, if you're playing a couple days a week, some, they were just charging $10 a person, and that's like 40 bucks a lesson for four people, and that was the doubles. That my friend was doing that, and then I was learning, you know, learning how to coach and stuff like that. I was only like 18 or 19, so I was charging people $5 a person to teach them how to play doubles, because a lot of people always want to, on returns of serve, they're always trying to go down the line, and they'll miss the serve, miss the return, and they'll be like, why am I missing this? I'm like, because the net's higher, and little things like that, and then hitting, trying to hit with a continental grip, with no topspin, not moving your feet. So we would practice stuff like that, and I like teaching people. I like teaching kids, and I like to try to be a good example on how to act on the tennis court and how to treat people in life and stuff like that. So I'm pretty good at teaching, and I taught tennis, and I was teaching football a little bit when I was in, you know, just when I finished high school, I was going to Daytona Beach Community College, and there was a couple guys out there that were playing the Amber Riddle, and I was teaching them some exercises to do to move laterally from playing tennis. So, because they were playing offensive linemen, and I was like, well, you gotta learn how to use lateral, and you should, you know, have an offensive line coach to help you with stuff too. So between some of my drills I taught them, they liked me, and I used to do that too. So basically I want to do teaching. I'm gonna get back into the workforce by teaching tennis, and maybe even going and finishing my degree in history, and see what I can do, you know. But right now, just getting better and losing the weight and having a better life for myself, that's my main that's my main purpose, and to help others the best I can with my channel and meet new people. So I do appreciate all the support. Thank you for coming out, you know, for watching the videos. I appreciate it, and thanks for all the input you guys leave back on advice on stuff. But it's fun coming out here with Ashley. She's good. She's getting really good at playing, and it's just fun to come out here. It's something you can do all your life, play tennis, you know. So, as I said before, thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe. And like I say, any advice you want to throw out there, and for support to others that are disabled or whatever, I appreciate it. And believe me, where everybody here is cool. And I have another channel called Sean Sweeney, where I exposed the NFL for being rigged and scripted, and I was right last week about all my picks, and I'm gonna be right about the Super Bowl. I say the Chiefs win 27-24, because it's 100% rigged and scripted, and the only reason I would think that the Niners might win is because of, you know, John Lynch and McCaffrey's dad, Ed McCaffrey, you know, Christian McCaffrey's dad, Ed McCaffrey, has some serious connections to gambling and the NFL and stuff. They're real deep in the organization, so if you know what I mean. So that could be something that you might want to look into if you're going to bet on these games. But I suggest not to bet on them, because they're 100% rigged and scripted, and anything can happen. So once again, that's a different channel. So people that come from that channel will come over here, and everybody's pretty, you know, pretty cool. We've been like knowing each other since I've been on the, had my channel for the last almost 10 years now. So I do appreciate everything. Thanks a lot, and God bless you.